Did you ever want to play your ukulele with a friend? Well then COVID hit and play along came quickly to an end. So we virtualized and put the chords and lyrics all online. So join us every Wednesday, 7 p.m. Eastern Time. So join us every Wednesday, 7 p.m. Eastern Time.
I'm just going to...
All right, welcome everyone to Wednesday. Happy St. Patrick's Day. I know there's competing things to do tonight, so... but we've looks like we've got a really good crowd, so really excited, and thank you for being here. We have a really good night tonight. We have some information about a giveaway we're doing. We've got a good variety of play-along songs, and we have Stu Fuchs. So we'll talk about Stu in just a minute. I always like to say, if you're here for the first time, welcome. Seriously, just so thrilled that you are here. I hope you find it worth your while. If you are new, go into the Facebook comments and tell us who you are. And you don't have to do that, but feel free. We would love to know who's new and would love to greet you. It's a great crowd. It's a good community that gathers here every Wednesday. Just a lot of people getting to know each other that have never met in person, but have become play along friends, and it's just a really exciting thing to do that. So let us know if you are new, and we will greet you. What else? So Stu, we are coordinating. I'm just going to make sure he is back on. But Stu Fuchs, if you are new to ukulele, if you've been around ukulele a bit, you most likely know who Stu Fuchs is. I will admittedly say Stu is the second video I watched on YouTube as I was first learning the ukulele. Cynthia Lynn just happened to show up first in search, and then I started getting a little more interested in different things, and then found Stu. So I've been watching Stu online for a long time. So Stu is a Grammy-nominated guitarist. That does not come easy. He's also presented ukulele workshops at festivals here in the U.S. and around the world. And then, you know, during the last 12 months has really ventured and done a lot online. So we're really fortunate to have Stu here tonight. I'm just so excited to have him here. So with that said, let's bring on Stu. Stu Fuchs, everybody.
Hello, everybody. Thank you so much for having me as a guest again, Greg. It's really great to be joining you, the Ukulele Gent. And this is a sweet community indeed. Hello to everybody in Florida. Hope you can hear me okay and you can see me okay. Yep. I am hailing from southern Vermont. And... my 13-month-old is soundly asleep. I don't hear any sounds from downstairs, so I think we're set to play full volume. And thank you for joining me. I wanted to share some ideas of finger style with you. And this is actually the topic of an entire workshop that I am offering on Sunday. It's an online workshop with perks, and I'll let you know about it if you'd like to join me. There is a 10% discount code that I'm going to extend to you. There are still a few tickets left if you'd like to join me. And what I'd like to do is share some concepts of finger picking in 3/4 time, briefly give you a little taste of what that workshop's going to be like. I'm going to share with you some ergonomic techniques, some techniques that I think not only give you a sweet tone, but will make it easier and easier to play. I'll demonstrate this on my low G ukulele and also my high G ukulele that's right down there. We're going to apply this pattern to the Wild Rover, which is one of the songs in the till tonight. So I'm just going to check my tuning real quick and then we'll get started. Now, finger style is a wonderful thing to incorporate into the ukulele. You know, in one sense, everything on the ukulele is finger style, unless, you know, you're using a pick. I recommend a wooden pick if you do. So, you know, we strum with our fingers. We... we always are picking with our fingers, but finger style, what I'm talking of, is specific patterns that create a rhythmic accompaniment, to accompany songs. It's a wonderful thing to do, and it also begins to open up possibilities for your solo playing. If you're interested in getting into chord soloing, chord melody, this is a great stepping stone. So let's get into it right now. I know you're itching to play, and we're going to get into some stuff right away, but let's just take 90 seconds, maybe 120 seconds, and do a quick technical check-in. Everyone, sit with your feet flat on the edge of your chair, if you're comfortable to do so, and bring your arm up like this. Look at your hand and see that your wrist is straight. Then what we're going to do is we're going to rest the arm on the upper bout of the ukulele. That's this part of the ukulele. And we're going to touch the strings. So what we're talking about are three P's: position, planting, and then we're going to pick. All right. I think we're at close to 30 seconds. Give me a few more 30-second blocks, and we're going to get into some real effortless picking. Now, my position is based on the concept of bring the uke to you, not you to the uke, because you'll twist your back a little bit and you play like that for a few hours and it cannot feel so good. So from your center, hold it. And now let's establish the planting point. I am rubbing my fingers on the strings. I encourage you to do the same thing right now. Rub your fingertips on the strings. And look at your fingers and see where the indentations are. You'll notice that mine are right where the tip of the finger meets the fingernail. Now, real quick, I want to let you know, you don't need fingernails to play fingerstyle. You don't play wonderfully without them. If you do choose to grow fingernails, you'll want to, file down this side and smooth it out. And keep a nail kit handy. I've had that same bag for 25 years. 1,000 or 1,500 grain sandpaper makes the surface of the nail very smooth, and you get a buttery tone. But let me make that totally clear. You do not need fingernails. So go ahead, find that planting point. And the idea is that we're touching the strings almost at the tip of the finger, because we don't want the string to get stuck, the finger to get stuck on the string, right? So now, 30 more seconds, and we're going to get into some playing. I'd like you to touch that planted position, and now we're going to pinch and release the strings all at once. And I'll do it first. Just watch me, please. See how my hand, it moves. And there's two really important points that I want to make clear to you, is that the hand isn't bouncing up. My wrist is still straight. That's point number one. The second point is that if you hold your hand up like this, it's moving from the third knuckle, you know? So if you've ever hung out with a toddler, I've been doing that a lot lately. You'll notice that this is kind of how they wave bye-bye. It's the third knuckle moving, very different than moving from the second knuckle, like if you were drawing a bow and arrow. All right, so we're waving bye-bye. Let's do this a few times, and just this time we're going to pluck the thumb, one. And now let's pluck those three strings. Index, middle, and ring are on the third, second, and first string. And we're just going to pluck thumb and then these two. And just follow through. Let's do it a second time. I'll begin. One, two, three. Your turn. Ready, go. One, two, three. Let's do it again. One, two, three. Awesome. What we're doing is we're playing this pattern. Three quarter notes. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3 is going to be a very great way to play Wild Rover, and we can bring this pattern and this pattern in to our strumming in 3/4 time. So we're going to hold a G chord down at a moment, but let me answer a very important question many people ask. Should I touch the top of the ukulele with my pinky? Well, the answer is it depends. If you're comfortable to do so, if you think that adds some stability to your playing, then go right ahead, please. Personally speaking, I didn't learn that way. I learned classical guitar technique where the anchor is not touching. It is touching the string. In fact, my hand is just floating. And I'm just moving through the air. There just happens to be a string in the way, right? So it feels much more relaxed when, for me, it's more relaxed when I don't touch. But you experiment, see what's more comfortable. This is a way to feel more free. So being able to move freely, much easier if you don't touch. So figure that out on your own, explore it on your own, and see what works. Let's hold down a G chord. So that's the technique. Okay, it took longer than 120 seconds, but thanks for hanging out with me. Remember, begin with your arm straight, wrist straight, plant, find that position, and let's keep a steady 3/4 rhythm. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Keep going. 1, 2, 3, 1. And this is what it sounds like. 2, 3, 1, high G. You can hear the rocking side to side of 3/4 time. Keep going, please. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and stop. Now, this is a gentler texture. So later when the song builds in intensity, you could bring in a different pattern with more juju in it, or go to a strum. 1, 2, and 3, 1, 2, and 3, 1, 2, and 3, 1, 2. Then you could always go back to the finger style if you want to create a softer texture. Having more colors on your palette, more choices, allows you to play the songs with more musicality and allows you to really create different sections, different varieties to all the sections in your playing. So let me know in the Facebook chat if you're enjoying this. I am not on the Facebook chat. I will check your comments later. Right now, I hope that you're doing well. Appreciate you joining me and, of course, joining Greg. And let's play The Wild Rover. This is the song sheet for the song The Wild Rover. And we'll play a bit of it right now, and then we'll explore that other pattern. Okay, so let's start with 1, 2, 3 picking, and then we will move on to a bit of strum. I'll stay on my low G ukulele for now. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, here we go, and begin. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1. I've been a wild rover for many a year. I've spent all my money on whiskey and beer. But now I'm returning gold in great store, and I'll never play the wild rover no more. And it's no, nay, never. No, never, no more. I will play
never, never no more.
Let's strum the second verse. One, two, three. One, verse two. I went to an alehouse I used to frequent. I told the landlady me money was spent. I asked her for credit, she answered me nay. Such custom as yours could have any day. Chorus, and it's no nay, never. No, never, no more. I will play the wild rover. No, never, never, no more. Let's go back to finger style here. And let's notice it's a softer sound, very light touch. Let's just fade out right now, a little softer each time. Thank you, everyone. So, I know I'm taking liberties with the melody. Thank you for hanging. Let's, while I'm still have some time with you, let's explore this pattern. This is a pattern that will build a lot of dexterity, and it's a pattern of eighth notes, one and two and three and, one and two and three and. The fingers we're going to be using would be your thumb, index, middle, index, then your ring finger, and then your index. There are other letters that are traditionally used, and that would be PIMA from the Italian pollice, indice, medio, anulare. So PIMAI. It creates a wonderful texture, especially if we begin to accent some of the notes by following through in a different way. Let's hold down our G major chord. Let me demonstrate. Just watch me play and focus on my right hand while you're watching. There's another way to play it where this last note could be played on this string with the middle finger. For right now, let's feel that the index finger is in there every other beat, and we have this texture popping out on top of these high notes. Yes, we're playing it slower because we're just learning the pattern. Now, as your finger style develops, and it takes time, you will develop a very natural feel for that follow-through motion I was talking about. All right. So I'm going to demonstrate this on my high G ukulele. And let's play a little more of the song. We'll go back to the chorus, but first let's practice this pattern. The pattern, hold your hand out like this and play thumb, index, middle, index, ring, index. Great idea. I feel it's a great idea to look at your hand and say it out loud. That way you create a feedback loop to the brain. You learn things with more sensory input, creating a stronger neural connection. You'll remember it more. So look at your hand and just say with me, thumb, index, middle, index, ring, index. One more time. And thumb, index, middle, index, ring, index. You could simply say the letters P-I-M-I-A-I.
P-I-M-I-A-I, P-I-M-I-A-I. And you could be doing this at a traffic light. Do, 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 do. You could do it on your sleeve while waiting for your number to be called at the deli. You know, this is practice, extra practice, where you not only are memorizing the pattern, but reinforcing what is it like just to move through the air very lightly. See how my pinky goes along for the ride? Once again, if you're comfortable to touch, cool, go for it. But you may find that there's a little bit of tension that's created when one part of your hand is being asked to stay still and the rest of it wants to take that for a ride, because after all, those tendons cross each other somewhere back here. All right, so you experiment, see what's comfortable for you. All right, my time is almost finished. Let's play a little bit. We'll do a speed test. I'm gonna do this very slow, and then we'll just go a little faster. As you go faster and faster, try less. You know, connect more with the soft motion. Here I go, I'll get it started. One and two and three and one and two and go. Keep that index finger really light and you'll hear. Now move to C. Back to G. D7 coming up, ready? Let's go back to G. Here we go. Let's pick it up just a little bit. Try less. Follow through. Go back to the Wild Rover, and what we're going to do is just play a little bit of it, and you strum if you prefer to strum 1 2 3 1 2 3. You can, if you prefer to play this thumb turn, pinch thumb pinch pinch pattern, you play that. If you want to try to mix in this 1 and 2 and 3 and 1 and 2 and 3, and eventually you have all of these to choose from. So we're going to go to that in just a second. I just want to let you know that I have a special workshop coming up, and I will be offering a discount to you if you are interested in coming, where we go deeper into finger style, and there are all kinds of perks included. Are bonus content, a jam track or two for you to practice with, a whole lot of songs that I'm going to be teaching you. I created a couple of etudes for you to study your finger style with. Right now, let's go to the chorus, okay? And it's no, nay, never, clap, 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 no, never, no more. I play the Wild Rover, no, never, never, no more. Let's just play the chorus with finger style. We'll take it a little slower just so we could practice this. And choose your pattern. Are you ready? One, two, start on D7. One, two, one, two, three, one. And it's no, nay, never. No, never, no more. I play the Wild Rover. No, never, never, no more. back to. Let's play the chorus again. No, it's no, nay, never. No, never, no more. I play the wild rover. No, never, never, no more. One more time, chorus. No, it's no, nay, never. No, never, no more. I'll play the wild rover. No, never, never, no more. D7. No, never, never, no more. One more. No, never, never, no more. So I was just demonstrating how you can use this to offer more texture to your playing, and you find your way into this in a way that feels really relaxed to you. So I hope you enjoyed this. We're just scratching the surface of what's possible with fingerstyle playing. Before I go, I just want to share something with you. And that is that I am offering a workshop about fingerstyle. And Greg, I believe, has a little bit of information he's putting in the chat. There still are some tickets left. You'll be receiving a whole bunch of bonus features, including, you know, you'll be able to watch the workshop as many times as you want. A day or two after we're finished with the live event, you can watch it and study as many times as you want. So even if you can't attend live, you can always watch as a replay. There are jam tracks. There's going to be a whole bonus section I'm going to be including about using fingerstyle as an improvisation method. Have some simple concepts and some simple methods to share with you about improvisation. We'll learn it in the key of C and in the key of G. So there's a lot that I'm going to be sharing with you in this workshop. So it's a workshop with perks is what I call it. If you'd like to join me, it's this Sunday at 3 p.m. Eastern, but you know, if you can't attend live, you can always watch as a replay. There are not many tickets left. So if you did want to join me, I hope that you'll visit my website soon while they're still available. There's only so many guests I can have. And there is a 10% discount code that is put in the chat. Greg, I believe you put it in the chat. So blah, blah, blah. Thank you for listening to me. Visit my YouTube channel. Every Sunday, there's a live stream lesson. Except this Sunday, of course, I'll be offering this special class. I hope that you're doing well and that you're enjoying yourself and that you and your family are healthy and weathering the pandemic and lockdown as well as you can. Music certainly helps. Thank you, Greg, for having me as a guest. Appreciate this very much.
Yes, Stu, thank you so much. What a treat. We had you back on in September. I'm just really thrilled you came back and joined us again. So thank you very much from me and from everyone watching. I'm looking at comments, and you'll see them later when you watch, but lots of great comments. So thank you.
Thank you.
Well, I'm going to bow out now, everyone, and just double check that our little toddler is still asleep. And you guys have a great jam with Greg. You're, of course, in great hands. Thank you for holding the space for everybody to jam. And Greg, thank you for having me as a guest.
All right. Appreciate it. Rowan and Sarah are doing well, and take care. We hope to see you soon.
Yeah, I hope so, too. Hopefully in person. All right. Take care, everybody.
Hey, thanks again.
Enjoy the warm weather for all us cold Vermonters up here.
I think it was like 83 here today, so we'll enjoy it for you. All right,
we had a heat wave. It was like 49 today. It's really, really warm.
I couldn't do it. All right, take care.
Thank you so much, Greg. Take good care.
Bet.
Thanks.
All right, just a little bit of housekeeping here. All right, so that was cool. So if anyone is new, I think most people probably have been here before. All of these sessions get recorded, so you can watch them back on Facebook. As soon as this is over, they're like 5 minutes later, it's available. I also, within a handful of days, put them on YouTube also. So depending on your TV setup, if you want to watch it on a big screen and you have some sort of smart TV that has YouTube on that, or even Facebook, they're available. So let's play some songs. Hello, Kathy, 39 in Iowa. Kim, oh my gosh. I mean, for Iowa at this time of year, that might not be that cold, but that sounds very cold. All right, so let's roll over to this one here. And again, if you are new, couple songs each week, we do a percussion. So we add a drum beat, and this is one of those songs. Actually, let me grab my uke before I put headphones on. So, and the percussions just come through. If you haven't been here before, you'll catch on real quick. It's easy. You're usually hitting that down strum on the drum beat. So if you're playing like an island strum, like we would do a lot, you would just play that like first down on that island strum and hit the beat. We'll vamp on that in just a moment. Let me go ahead and start that. So we're just gonna vamp on G for a moment. Tom is saying his weather is oddly like mine. It's amazing. You'd think there'd be more of a weather variation four houses away. Tom is a nearby neighbor. So hey, Tom. All right, so that's really it. Down, down, up, up, down, 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 up, up, down, up, down, up. Hey, Mom and Dad. That Mike and Carol Gent in the comments. That is my wonderful parents. All right, we're gonna get rolling because I think you guys want to play some music. So let's do that. One, a two, a one, two, three, and. Father's here, hear the yell. Back to school, ring the bell. Brand new shoes, walking blue. Climb the fence, books and pens. Oh, I can tell that we are gonna be friends. I can tell that we are gonna be friends. Walk with me, Susie Lee. Through the park and by the tree, we will rest upon the ground and look at all the bugs we found. Safely walk to school without a sound. Safely walk to school without a sound. Verse 3. Here we are, no one else. Walk to school all by ourselves. There's dirt on our uniforms from chasing all the ants and worms. We clean up and now it's time to learn. We clean up and now it's time to learn. Numbers, letters, learn to spell. Nouns and books and show and tell. At playtime we will throw the ball. Back to class, through the hall. Teacher marks our hide against the wall. Oh, teacher marks our hide against the wall. We don't notice any time passed.
we don't notice anything. We sit side by side in every class. Teacher thinks that I sound funny, but she likes the way you sing. Tonight I'll dream while I'm in bed, when silly thoughts go through my head about the bugs and alphabets. When I wake tomorrow, I bet that you and I will walk together again. I can tell that we are gonna be friends. Yes, I can tell that we are gonna be friends.
All right. Hey, Kirk Jones. Hey, I see Kirk Jones typing in the comments. Next week, Kirk Jones is going to be here as our guest. So that's going to be fun. Kirk is just fun. He does fun mashups, just a very inventive method of playing, and you're going to get a kick out of Kirk. So tune in next week. And I'm going to talk about a promo shortly, but not quite yet. You probably want to play a couple songs before we go into talking. All right. So this is a little, since it's St. Patrick's Day, this shirt is like a very odd color green, but it's the only greenish color shirt I have. So if it doesn't look green, maybe I can edit that somehow, color correct that somehow. Hey, Deidre. Okay, and then, so Kirk Jones is next week, and then the week after that, which would be the 31st, is going to be a 1 year. We started doing this 1 year ago. So we're going to have a little 1 year event. What we're going to do, see, I said I wasn't going to talk, and now I'm talking. But what we're going to do, and I mentioned that last week, on the 1 year, because truly, this is about this community. Right now we've got 130 people. I saw someone from Germany earlier. We've had Philippines and Australia. If Val Rowe is here, she's pretty regular from Australia. So all over the country. It's just turned into this really fun community that just gathers on Wednesdays and just has fun together. So why did I bring that up? Oh, to tell you that we're having a 1 year. So to do the 1 year, since this really truly is about the people who join and the community that you all are part of, we are going to do, on the 31st, we are going to have the play along led by you. So I'm busy collaborating with people who have volunteered. And then we are going to have that day, we're going to play a bunch of collaborations. So it'll still be a play-along, but it'll be a play-along kind of co-led by you all. So if you want to do that, if you're looking to, wouldn't mind or interested in collaborating and being part of that, contact me through Facebook. Just send me a direct message and we will take care of that. We'll get that rolling and you will be part of next week's show. So that'll be fun. I'm looking forward to that. And I'm having a blast doing all these collaborations with a bunch of different people in a bunch of different locations. So a bunch of different styles of music. It's a blast. It's really fun. So really looking forward to that. All right. So we have Pub with No Beer because it's St. Patty's Day. That's where I started here. And we're going to do sort of a... like a down, 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 up, down, down, up, down, down, up, that pattern. And I'm getting that, my string closest to my chin, my G string. So I'm doing, I'm going down, down, I'm plucking with my thumb, and then I'm doing a down, and then coming up. Over and over. So let me just go back to that real quick. So that's it. Up here, I'm plucking the G. So that's a down. Essentially, that's a down. Down, up. Down, up. Pluck, down, up. Pluck, down, up. Okay, so that's what we're going to do, the whole song, pretty much, for this little Irish tune. Let me go back here. All right, so Pub with No Beer. The tune cut sort of goes, it's lonesome away from your kindred and all, by the campfire at night when the wild dingoes call. You'll get it. There's like 30 verses to this song, so... that's an exaggeration, but there's a lot of verses. There's no chorus, but there's a lot of verses. All right, so you're ready. So let's get that first. Let's hold that G. Oh, it's lonesome. Oh, let's do that. Come away from your kindred and all. By the campfire at night where the wild dingoes call. But there's nothing so lonesome, morbid or drear, than to stand at the bar of a pub with no beer. Now the publican's anxious for the quota to come. There's a faraway look on the face of a bum. The maid's gone all cranky and the cook's acting queer. What a terrible place is a pub with no beer. You getting that strum? Then the stockman rides up with his dry dusty throat. He breasts up to the bar, pulls a wad from his coat. But the smile on his face quickly turns to a sneer as the barman says sadly, the pub's got no beer. Then the swaggy comes in smothered in dust and flies. He throws down his roll, rubs the sweat from his eyes. When he is told, he says, what's this I hear? I've trudged 50 flaming miles to a pub with no beer. There's a dog on the veranda for his master, he waits. But the boss is inside drinking wine with his mates. Ooh, this one needs a little more practice. Ah, he hurries for cover and he cringes in fear. It's no place for a dog round a pub with no beer. Verse 6. It's a long one, I told you that. Old Billy the blacksmith, the first time in his life, had gone home gold sober to his darling wife. Walks in the kitchen, she says, you're early, my dear. Then he breaks down and tells her the pub's got no beer. Oh, it's hard to believe that there's customers still, but the money's still tinkling in the old ancient till. The wine buffs are happy, and I know they're sincere when they say they don't care if pub's got no beer. So it's lonesome away from your kindred and all, by the campfire at night where the wild dingoes call. But there's nothing so lonesome, morbid or drear, than to stand in the bar of the pub with no beer. Woo! That was a little rough. All right, let's move on. Okay, Song Sung Blue. We have never done this song before, not here. I mean, I do want to show you something real quick. So I talked about people, and someone had asked about this, Katie Thomas, who's from the UK. She asked about the states. So just for fun, right, I have been keeping track of this. For a little while, not since the beginning, because I really wasn't thinking about it. But the yellow-ish shading over the aerial map, that's people from those states have tuned in to this show. So we're making progress. This community has grown. So if you're from Oregon tonight, let us know. Put something in the comments and tell us you're here. Or Idaho, Wyoming, North Dakota, Arkansas, Mississippi, and Little Delaware. So if you're from any of those states, let us know in the comments. That would be great. All right, enough about that. Let's go back here. All right, so as I've said before, first time we do a song here, you gotta lower your expectations. Karen Bly, you really are from Arkansas and Oregon. Ha ha, yes. You know, wouldn't that be great if we finished all those states at the same time we celebrated 1 year? That'd be awesome. All right, so if you are from Oregon, let me know. And Maine. Fantastic. All right, so Song Sung Blue. Very easy strum. We're just going to do a down, down, up, up, down, up pretty much the whole time.
Song Sung Blue, everybody knows one.
Right? So very easy strum. So we're just going to vamp on C. There's a different intro to this, but we're just going to stick with a vamp on C and get rolling. Are you ready? Let's vamp on C. Yeah, my shirt sort of does match the color on the map. That's a good observation, Diane. Not the plan at all. Are you ready?
Song Sung Blue, everybody knows one. Song Sung Blue, every garden grows one. Me and you are subject to the blues now and then. When you take the blues and make a song, you sing them out again. You sing them out again. Song Sung Blue, weeping like a willow. Song Sung Blue, sleeping on my pillow. Funny thing, but you can sing it when you cry in your voice. Before you know it, it's the feeling good. You simply got no choice. Subject to the blues now and then. But when you take the blues and make a song, you sing them out again. You sing them out again. Song Sung Blue, weeping like a willow. Song Sung Blue, sleeping on my pillow. Funny thing, but you can sing it with a cry in your voice. And before you know it, started feeling good. You simply got no choice. Song Sung Blue, everybody knows one. Song Sung Blue, every garden grows one. Funny thing, but you can sing it with a cry in your voice. And before you know it, started feeling good. You simply got no choice. You
simply got no choice. All right, first attempt. Neil Diamond, song sung blue. I'm just reading some comments here. So people are talking. I don't have any names for any of my ukuleles. Not one. Okay, the unicorn song. So I wanted to do some Irish songs tonight. And this came up, right? You're searching. This is like in terms of Irish songs, for some reason, this is very big. A group called the Irish Rovers made this a huge hit in Ireland. This is actually written by Shel Silverstein. If you don't know Shel Silverstein, he wrote The Giving Tree and lots of really popular children's books. He also wrote a bunch of songs. So Google Shel Silverstein. You'll be amazed at some of the songs you probably didn't know he wrote. But for me, when I think of this song, in spite of the Irish Rovers, yes, great, they did it. And in spite of Shel Silverstein, when I think of this song, I think of Pete McCarty. And if you don't know Pete, we'll talk about Pete in just a minute. But and Pete's probably going to cringe when he hears me say that. But he plays this on a show that he does, and it's hilarious. And anytime I hear the song, that's what I think of. I think of Pete. So because of that, Pete was just extremely nice and helped out with this, because I didn't want to do this just me, because it just didn't seem right. If this song was going to be done, Pete would at least be part of it. So Pete is part of it. So here you go. And Pete, thank you.
Long-necked geese, humpback camels and chimpanzees, some rats and cats and elephants, but sure as you're born, the loveliest of all was the unicorn. Now God seen some sinning and it gave him pain. He said, stand back, I'm gonna make it rain. He said, hey brother Noah, I'll tell you what to do, build me a floating zoo. And take some of them green alligators, long-necked geese, humpty-back camels and chimpanzees, some cats and rats and elephants, but sure as you're born, but don't forget my unicorn.
Old Noah was there to answer the call, and he finished up making the arches as the rain started falling. Marched to the animals two by two, called out as they went through, hey Lord, I got you.
Green alligators and long-necked geese, humpty back camels and chimpanzees, some cats and rats and elephants, but Lord and forlorn, I just don't see no unicorn. Then Noah looked out through the driving rain. Them unicorns were hiding, playing silly games, kicking and a splashing while the rain was pouring. All them silly unicorns.
There was
green alligators and long-necked geese, humpty-back camels and chimpanzees. Noah cried, close the door, cause the rain is pouring in.
We just can't wait for
unicorns. The ark started moving, it drifted with the tide. Them unicorns looked up from the rocks and they cried. The waters come down and sort of floated them away. And that's why you never see a unicorn to this very day. But
you'll see
green alligators and long-necked geese, humpty-back camels and chimpanzees, some cats and rats and elephants, but sure as you're born, you're never gonna see the unicorn. You're never gonna see the unicorn. Never gonna see the unicorn. Thank you, Pete.
Oh boy, that was fun. That was fun. All right, let me do something real quick here. All right, so I have had people tell me or ask me, right? They say, okay, so you're doing this thing on Wednesdays. That must be a whole lot easier when you play a video instead of singing, right? Instead of just doing a song, playing a video, right? They said that's easier. And I said, no, it's not easier. So let me dispel that myth of videos being easier or guests being easier. And I'm not saying guests are difficult. Guests are great. It just takes some coordination. So that video right there, we'll use Pete as an example. It's not a simple thing. It starts off with a request for time off from work. And you might say, well, why would you request time off from work? The show's in the evening. Well, and it's not a full day, but it's a half day maybe. And that's so you can get down to the bank and fill out the paperwork for a second mortgage so you can afford to pay Pete, because Pete ain't cheap. So that's step one, right? Now, once you've secured the funding, then you get a hold of Pete, or you try to get a hold of Pete through Pete's handlers, right? You just don't talk directly to Pete. It's a whole handler thing. There's a whole list of demands. Pete wants a unicorn at every performance venue he's at. And unicorns, as you know, they're extremely hard to get a hold of, especially hard to transport even. So there's that. And finally, a whole negotiation of demands. So it's not easy. He's hard to get a hold of. Pete's probably Joe Biden during a presidential campaign is easier to get a hold of than Pete is. So if that gives you any idea. So finally, it all comes down to that. So if any of you know Pete, right, you know what I'm talking about. I mean, all these things, all these... I'm trying to keep a straight face. All these things... So if you know Pete, you do know. You know that he's probably the nicest guy on the planet. Everything I've said is just a joke. And I really am thankful. And I want to bring this up. I want to show this real quick here. So that is a screenshot of what we were just showing a second ago. Right? That was the song we were doing. That's a screenshot from when we were doing that song. So if you look at Pete, he's smiling because he pretty much always is. If you look where he is, so today I think is day 368. So a little over a year ago, Pete started doing a show every day to, you know, give something to people that were in lockdown and just not able to get out and see people. So he did this every day. He thought it was going to last a couple weeks. And it lasted a couple weeks, a couple months, and he just hit 1 year. He's done this over 367 times, I think it would be now. So what you're looking at is where Pete works. And he sneaks away from work. I don't know if he sneaks. But he leaves work and goes into this this closet at work. And he performs. He does this show every single workday. On the weekend, he does it from his home, sometimes by himself, sometimes with his wife, Dee. But so there was a bit of a celebration. I just want to just really add to that in a small way and just say, Pete, that's an amazing thing that you did. You gave a lot of cheer, a lot of joy, a lot of hope to a lot of people for a lot of months. So, Pete McCarty... thank you for doing that. If you've never seen Pete in the daytimes, I'm not sure how long he's going to continue that. He isn't either, but for right now, he still is. So it's usually about 2:30 in the afternoon, Eastern time. You can look up Pete McCarty on Facebook. I'm sure someone will add that into the comments if anyone's curious. But Pete, seriously, awesome. Good job. Kudos. Very, very well done, and so many are appreciative of that. So thank you. All right. And I really did have fun with that with Pete, and he's really not demanding. That was a joke. All right, let's go back to lyrics here. That's not a lyric, although that's quite a picture there. So let's go back to lyrics. All right, we have never done this song before either. It's pretty risky, right? To do all these songs first time. That first Irish song, that was really bad. I did that, and I think I just got the tune wrong in my head. I don't know what happened there, so apologies for that. But this is a little interesting, because if you look, all the chords are seventh. So A7, D7, E7, C7. And if you know the song, it's by the Mamas and the Papas. And this one, we were going to do a drum machine also. So let me get that drum machine going again. Alrighty. All right, so let's just vamp on that again, on that A7. That's what we're going for right there. John and Mitchie, we're getting kind of itchy, right? We're not starting yet. That's it. All right, here we go. A one, a two, a one, two, three, and. John and Mitchie were getting kind of itchy just to leave the folk music behind. Zal and Denny working for a penny, trying to get a fish on the line. In a coffee house, Sebastian sat, and after every number, they passed the hat. Gwen and McGuire just to get higher in L.A., you know where that's at. No one's getting fat except Mama Cass. Zalas and Denny, you know there aren't many who can sing the song the way that you do. Let's go south. Denny said, Zolly golly, don't you think that I wish I could play guitar like you? Zal, Denny, and Sebastian sat, after every number they passed the hat. McGuinn and McGuire still are getting higher in L.A., you know where that's at. No one's getting fat except Mama Cass. Right? If you've never done the drum machine, you getting it? Down. Down. All right, verse 3. Cass was a sophomore, planned to go to Swarthmore, but she changed her mind one day. Standing on the turnpike, thumb out the hitchhike, take me to New York right away. When Daddy met Cass, he gave her love bumps, called John Zell, and that was the mugwumps. Gwen and McGuire couldn't get no higher, that's where they were aiming at. No one's getting fat except Mama Cass. Verse 4, here we go. Mug bumps, high jumps, slow bumps, beat bumps, don't you work as hard as you play. Make up, break up, everything you shake up, guess it had to be that way. Sebastian and Zal's formed the Foom Club, Michelle, John, and Denny getting very tuneful. McGuinn and McGuire just to catch a fire in L.A., you know where that's at. And everybody's getting fat except Mama Cass. We got some tongue twisters here. Broke, busted, disgusted, ages can't be trusted, and Mitchie wants to go to the sea. Cass can't make it, she says we'll have to fake it, she knew we'd come eventually. Racing on American Express, got in slow rent. We're keeping up the heat's hot, Duffy's good vibration, and our imagination can go on indefinitely.
California dream, it is becoming a reality.
Not the best song for my voice, but hopefully that's some new variety, some new songs here. All right, so we're going to talk about this real quick. I'm trying to mix songs in with the talking. So let's go back here and go back here into this. And so this, wait, not there. This one. Yes. All right. So in 2 weeks, we are, like I said, we're having our, you know, kind of a little 1 year anniversary of doing this. It's all going to be songs collaborated with people who watch. So that's going to be a blast. And we're also giving away an iPad. So I know Android people, I'm sorry, we use Apple products more than we use Android products. Very sorry. But what scrolls the chords and lyrics when we do this is an app called OnSong. And that app, sadly, not sure why, is only available on Apple devices. we also started lately using a cappella a bit, and it's to do those collaboration videos. So, excuse me for a moment. Mm-hmm. So we are going to give away an iPad. And it's a, you know, full size 10.2. It's the 8th generation, if that means anything to you. iPad. But we're also going to be giving away OnSong and a cappella. So that's going to be cool that we're doing that, I think. So somebody's going to be, walk away with something to do all these things with. Store their music, scroll their music, and then collaborate. But to do this, how this is going to work is next week when Kirk Jones is on, to be eligible for the drawing is going to take place on March 31st. To be eligible for the drawing that takes place on March 31st, you have to go to Facebook and either say interested or going to the event next week. That makes sense. So you can do both of them. You can say you're interested in going to the 24th and the 31st. But on the 31st, we are going to take all the people that registered for the 24th, and then we're going to do a drawing on the 31st. So go to Facebook, follow or like this page, because you know you'll get notifications of songs being put out there. But you got to do that, or else on the 31st, your name will not be in the hat. So go to the site. Go interested or going to the event on the 24th and then on the 31st. It's just too close. I can't have people register for the 31st and use that list because people will be registering right to the last minute and it'll be too crazy. So I need to plan a week in advance. Enough talking, I know. But that's what we're going to do. And we're going to give away the iPad. So stay tuned for that. Sign up and then join us. Join us for Kirk Jones and then join us for our 1 year. All right, back to the lyrics. I should, I'm not being very chatty with people in the comments and I apologize. There's just my head can only take so much. Okay, Tom. Well, that's very generous. I don't know if knowing me should exclude you from that, but that's nice of you. Very nice. All right, so we are going to do Riptide. probably know this song. The strum on this, it goes into just a down, down, up, up, down, up once the song gets going. But that very beginning, we're going to do something just slightly different. The A minor, so the first two lines of the intro are going to sound something like this. I'm going to do it slow first. So it's. Okay, so we're doing down, two downs on the A minor. Okay, so, and then we're going to go, and it's going to, trust me, it's going to go faster than that. And then we're going to go into just. Right? So, that's what we're aiming for. Again, this is recorded, so you can always go back. Just if you go back and watch this, don't watch that first Iris song. I'm gonna have to go back and watch. I think that was really bad, but I'm well over that. I got over months ago, many months ago, being afraid to sound not great. Because if this Wednesday night were about me or my singing, it would have ended a long time ago. All right, there we go. Riptide. Dark. I was scared of pretty girls and starting conversations. All my friends are turning green. You're the magician's assistant in their dreams. Ah-ooh. Ah-ooh. And they come unstuck. Lady, running down to the riptide, taken away to the dark side. I wanna be your left-hand man. I love you when you're singing that song, and I got a lump in my throat, cause you're gonna sing the words wrong. There's this movie that I think you'll like. This guy decides to quit his job and heads to New York City. This cowboy's running from himself. She's been living on the highest shelf. Ah-ooh. Ah-ooh. And they come unstuck. Lady, running down to the riptide, taken away to the dark side. I wanna be your left-hand man. I love you when you're singing that song, as I got a lump in my throat, cause you're gonna see the words wrong. I just wanna know if you're gonna stay. I just gotta know. I can't have it any other way. I swear she's destined for the screen. Closest thing to Michelle Pfeiffer that you'd ever seen. Oh, lady, running down to the riptide, taken away to the dark side. I wanna be your left-hand man. I love you when you're singing that song, and I got a lump in my throat, cause you're gonna sing the words wrong. Lady, running down to the riptide, taken away to the dark side. I wanna be your left-hand man. Love you when you're singing that song, as I got a lump in my throat, cause you're gonna sing the words wrong. I got a lump in my throat, cause you're gonna sing the words wrong. Alrighty. So did that happen? Did we really have somebody from Oregon? There's a lot of people in Oregon. And I'm betting a lot of them play ukulele, right? So that'll be great. If you are getting here later, if you missed Stu, he was giving a lesson on fingerstyle, but also talking about a workshop that he has in like 4 days from now. So you can check out his website. That will have all the information on Stu. You're welcome, Mom. For Riptide. Alright, I'm gonna make sure I have this tune in my head. I spent all me money on whiskey and beer. I think that's kind of how it goes. Now I'm returning with gold in great store, and I never will play the Wild Rover no more. All right, so I'll show one thing different as well. It's pretty much the same strum as the other. 1 second, let's go to this close-up. So one thing I am doing here, I'm not using my thumb. I am using my finger, and I'm just sort of nicking. I'm nicking that G string instead of plucking it with my thumb. I could do it with my thumb, but it's just sort of a it's an easier for me, a little easier strumming technique, and I'm just doing. You're getting the same effect, but instead of plucking that with my thumb, I'm just getting it. But you got to be careful not to hit the C string, because you're just sort of nicking it and then snapping back and then strumming full. So let's see if we can do this one a little better than last one. Clearly I'm not Irish. That's not what we want. Clearly I'm not Irish. All right, here we go. Donna, are you saying this song is slow? Yes.
I've been a wild rover for many a year. I spent all me money on whiskey and beer. But now I'm returning with gold in great store. And I never will play the Wild Rover no more. And it's no, nay, never. No, nay, never, no more will I play the Wild Rover. No, never, no more.
I think that sounds a little better than last one.
I went into an alehouse I used to frequent. And I told the landlady me money was spent. I asked her for credit, she answered me nay. Such custom as yours I can't have any day. And it's no, nay, never. No, nay, never, no more will I play the Wild Rover. No, never, no more. I took out of me pocket 10 silverins bright, and the landlady's eyes opened wide with delight. She said, I have whiskies and wines on the best, and the words that I told you were only in jest. And it's no, nay, never. No, nay, never, no more will I play the Wild Rover. No more.
Alright, verse 4.
I'll go home to my parents, confess what I've done, and ask them to pardon their prodigal son. And when they've caressed me as oft times before, I never will play the Wild Rover no more. And it's no, nay, never. No, nay, never, no more will I play the Wild Rover. No, never, no more. And it's no, nay, never. I played once over. No, never, no more.
That's really awkward to do. And I say that because normally you're in a bar, like you're in an Irish pub on St. Patrick's Day, and there's, you know, 100 people half drunk or fully drunk, and it's not the same when you're just sitting in an empty office by yourself. It's not the same. But happy St. Patrick's Day. All right, so let's see what is left. Folks, this is the last song. Let me check my my little agenda. Okay, we had Stu, check. We had Pete, check. Did the little joke with Pete, check. we talked about states, yes, check. We talked about the iPad giveaway and the rules for that. And I'm going to put the rules on the Ukulele Gent Facebook page. And and that's it. I think we have achieved our goals. All right, here we go. We're not starting yet, don't worry. All right, here we go. So let's talk about that last line. And it's like, oh, how I wish I had someone to talk to. I'm in an awful way. I got in town a month ago. So those four D7s, you're just doing downs. They come really quick and you go right to that G on the verse. You'll get it. If you don't, no biggie, you can watch back. And let me say one more time, because we still got quite a few people on. If you do want to collaborate for a song that will be played as the play-along on the 31st, please let me know. I need, I think, three or so more. So please let me know if you want to do that. If you're frightened by doing that, you know, sometimes those little steps that feel a little fearful are the good ones, and they take you. I was talking with someone today doing it, and we had used a drum machine, and she was always used to just playing by herself, and then people would collaborate with what she had done. So she had never collaborated really with others. But I went first, so she was forced to go second. She had to listen to the drum machine, so she said it was a great exercise for her. So you'll have fun, you'll learn, right? And then we'll get to play them on the 31st. It'll be a lot of fun. All right. Are we ready? Another Saturday night. See if we can do this one fairly well. All right. One, two. A one, two, three. Another Saturday night, and I ain't got nobody. I got some money because I just got paid. Now I wish I had someone to talk to. I'm in an awful way. Got in town a month ago. I've seen a lot of girls since then. If we can meet them, I can get them. As yet I haven't met them. That's why I'm in the shape I'm in. Oh, another Saturday night, and I ain't got nobody. Got some money cause I just got paid. How I wish I had someone to talk to. I'm in an awful way. Another fella told me he had a sister who looked just fine. Instead of being my deliverance, she had a strange resemblance to a cat named Frankenstein. Oh, another Saturday night, and I ain't got nobody. Got some money cause I just got paid. How I wish I had some chick to talk to. I'm in, wait, sorry, I'm in an awful way. It's hard on a feather when he don't know his way around.
me a honey to help me spend my money. I'm gonna have to blow this town. Oh, another Saturday night, and I ain't got nobody. Got some money cause I just got paid. How I wish I had some chick to talk to. I'm in an awful way.
And then we have a key change here, ready?
Another Saturday night, and I ain't got nobody. I got some money cause I just got paid. How I wish I had someone to talk to. I'm in an awful way. I'm in an awful way.
Sorry about that. I meant to tell you about that key change. I didn't mean to spring it on you like that. So sorry about that. All right. I'm interested. Sue. Okay, Sue. Well, I know how to get a hold of you, Sue. I don't need to say contact me. All right. I'll be in touch. But really, folks, those are the things. Trust me. I don't want to talk about me, but doing this show has made me better. And you might not agree with that. You might not agree with that, but it really has. I don't want to seem totally incompetent when I'm trying to, you know, do songs for you so you can play along with. So I practice, right? So this has forced me to practice way more than I ever would. So some of these little things, if you know you're going to be part of a collaboration that's going to be heard by, you know, a number of people, you'll probably practice harder than you've practiced and learn maybe some things you didn't learn. So I would just say stretch yourself. I'm happy to help. In any way I can with the technology or anything. So enough talking. For those who are here the first time, thank you. I hope it was worth your while for this hour and a half of your life. There's other things you could be doing. You could be at a St. Paddy's party. You could be celebrating at your home with green beer. You could be doing something other than being here. So it really is appreciated that you're here. For sure. Next week, Kirk Jones. Again, check out Kirk online, Facebook, YouTube. Just super fun guy. Kirk, we still have a little work to do. So we will be in touch with each other. So come back for Kirk Jones next week. I think you'll really like that. And then after that, like I said, is our little one year thing. So thank you very much, y'all. It really is being fun being part of this, and I really am glad that you are part of this. So thank you. I genuinely mean that, and I'm thankful you are here, and I'm thankful we are a Wednesday night community. So let's keep this going. Have a fantastic week, and we will see you next Wednesday, 7 p.m. If you have a friend that plays the uke and they haven't come, invite them. If you haven't liked, so what I will do is after this, probably tonight, I'll go ahead and do it. I will publish all of the songs for tonight. I'll put them in a Dropbox folder. You don't need a Dropbox account. I will put that Dropbox link, the link to that Dropbox folder on the Facebook page, the Ukulele Gent Facebook page. So it'll tell you how to get there. If you click on that link and your computer says, or Dropbox says, hey, sign up for a Dropbox account, just click no. You don't have to have a Dropbox account. If you click cancel, it'll go right to the file, and then you'll have the file. And you can download all the song sheets. And all the previous song sheets are there too. They're in the key we did them, so you're sort of stuck with that. But hopefully that's okay. I didn't used to publish the songs, but so many people asked that I've started doing that a few months back. So, Kaz, we're glad you stayed up late. Donna, enjoy your Baileys. Robin, you're welcome. Janice, I'm glad it was fun, and we will see you next week. So take care, everybody. See you next week. Ciao. Bye. Happy St. Patrick's Day.
Ukulele. Ukulele Gent.